goodness for that, to be honest. Oh, there is no shop. Well, none of the shops were good. None of them. Oh well. It's all luck. Bye. No. Oh, shoot! I forgot to use my prayer card after I beat Loam. That was foolish. Foolish. Would have given me an eternal heart, and then it would have filled the eternal heart up into a red heart when I changed into the level. Oh well. That fly, the spikes don't hurt me. What's this? It is a fart. Bad gas gives you a fart cloud that does poison damage to anything close to it. It is situationally useful, but very rarely. There we go. Anyway. Your card would be a lot more useful if it, like, dropped on the ground, or if the eternal heart gives you a drop on the ground instead of going right into your inventory or your heart meter. Anyway, let's gamble. Very Fairy Gaming and any of my advertisers don't promote gambling in this. I guess they do promote gambling, but I don't. You shouldn't gamble in real life. It's a waste of money. Edmund, stop being edgy and just give me stuff. Give me stuff. Give me. Eh. This is why gambling is bad. It's a waste of time, and you don't even get anything good out of it. I got a tongue. I got Judas's tongue. Ripped it right out of his mouth. Ah. Oh, and the womb. And further. All hits you take do full heart damage instead of half heart damage. It's great. Ow. Anyway, this is Horror of Babylon. It turns you into a giant flying demon who kicks butt. What do you have? Just half a heart. Couldn't just fall out of here. Goodbye. I'm just looking for a... okay. Well, that was nice, it took me to the boss fight. I'm gonna keep looking for the... Oh, there we go. Here's a super secret room. Photo. There we go. Okay. The left hand makes it so you're more likely to get devil chests, which are the red and black ones. And sometimes they have guppy items in them. Or sometimes they have shit like bombs in them. And we want devil chests because I really, really, really want Guppy's paw. Sometimes Guppy's items are in devil chests. Another kicker of this boss fight is that the prize is always a hobby horse, and it gives you flight. And guess who already has flight? It's me. God. That lighter gives me a chance of getting, go away. Words, soul hearts. I'm not gonna take that half a heart because I need to have the half health left in my inventory. Oh good, more money. That's useful at this point in the game. Yeah, leave me alone. Stop. Locate, you're being rude. Lucky toe. That's cancer. I'll take cancer. Because it doesn't look like I'm going to be getting a guppy item. Or guppy spa. Yes, okay, I'll check that. Oh, I almost got the sad onion. I'm going to take that over the, card. Soul hearts are more useful to Eve than not soul hearts. Anyway, now I know where the boss room is. Sorry gents. I'm leaving. About cancer, which, you know, is a sentence you can only say in this game, is that it breaks the cap on your tier rate. So if you get items that give you more tier rate and it goes above your max limit for tiers, then you just have, you go above your top. You just get them. Usually you wouldn't. But you do. That was not a very well put together sentence, and I apologize for that. Hi, Ruffin. That's good to see. I'm gonna hold on to you. And since I really, really want Gummy's paw, I'm gonna go up to the curse room. So, at least leaving all those soul hearts behind. And the reason for that is that I really, really, really... When you're playing Eve, you want your Horror Babylon mode to go on for as long as possible. And the best way to do that is to get the Polaroid and lots of soul hearts. And those combine really nicely, because the soul hearts, whenever you take damage, you lose a soul heart instead of a red heart. And the Polaroid gives you a shield that protects you for a while. And you're just really powerful with Horror Babylon active. So, you know, it's really useful. And these guys don't always shoot you unless you're not shooting. Come on. There we go. Okay. Those are spiders. Sigh. Super secret room? Nope. To the chest. I'm gonna try to get to the chest. Anyway, we're gonna let ourselves go down to just half a heart and come back and get all those soul hearts. It's a risky game you play with Eve, but if you get it to work out, it's worth it. Puts two soul hearts down on the floor. Which is understandably useful. Well, get up there. There we go. Soul hearts. Doop. Remember, you can have more hearts. Oh, yeah, I remember now. It shrinks. Heart menu. Or the life counter thing. So you can have more hearts than just the 12. That's one thing this game has over Rebirth. Rebirth is better in almost every other way from what I've seen, but except for that. I don't actually have Rebirth. Again, if anyone wants to give it to me, that would be pretty cool. Alright. Meet me in the pit. Whatever. good. Better to the part where she stays down. There we go. I want to go to the chest, so that means going to the cathedral first.